But I wanted to see it. You like both. Now I'm getting relaxed. Now I'm going to see it. I put a lot of attention on craftsmanship because I believe that this is what really artists talk about. I believe that a lot of artists believe that they are saying things on their work. Let's say they're making a statement about ecological things, political things, philosophical, whatever. But they're not really making any of this. This is my opinion. They're always making personal statements. And the personal statements are made in the way they make their statements. This is what I see. I always read on the way the things are made. So this is why craftsmanship is so important to me. I always let people read how my objects are made. All the screws that I use, people can see them. So people can read the time I spend on my objects. It's like I show the love I put into it. It's my affection to my objects, my time. This is the way it's made. This is my gift. I show it. And you may be trying to say something, but at the end you're always talking about yourself. Whatever choices you made, you talk about yourself, the color you choose, the size of the painting you choose. If you make a huge painting, you say something about yourself. If you make a small painting like this, you say something about yourself. If you make it aggressive, you could be trying to say a philosophical statement or whatever, but what you're saying is with the side you choose, with the way you wrote it, with the, everything is the way you say it. To me, this is the way I read art. And I only read art the way people say it. I'm not proud of this. But I go to art museums and I go to art galleries and I never read statements on the wall. Because it may not be enriching, I may lose a lot of information. You may be stupid, I may be whatever. But if the object, I get what I get from the object, what the object says. If he says something good, if he doesn't, he doesn't. But what he says is what the object says to me. He says what the artist left there. It's not what he pretended to say, it's not what the writer wrote the text to say it says, it's not, you know, I read the things people say about what they think I am, or what they think I am, I never see myself on it, never, or rarely, very rarely. This is a card I made. The pictures are very good. but these are pieces of electronic. I made it like a good long, 17 feet by 14 feet. These are hard to read, but these are keyboards. All pieces of electronics, maybe some of you see from back there. And then they just place it and they prove it. Technically. I just stayed there 10 days on my knees, started from here, and then I clean it. Just to see. Just to see that I can make it. Just because electronics cannot be a car. I think that breakfast or these all of you coming to see me about business, the art business. I don't really understand much of it. I'm successful as much as it could be, I don't really know how it works. I think that most of the people in the art world is pretty dishonest. Very pretentious. Snob. Not very educated. Not very interesting. I don't do any loving for myself. Don't go to cocktails. And when I go, I say things I shouldn't say. And I pay for it. I don't get that many opportunities because of it. I'm so sad because people like my work. People buy it. But I don't get many opportunities and institutions and things like that because I say things that people don't like. I'm not good at it. I'm not proud of it. I should be better at it. But I'm not. I'm not because I'm not. I don't like art magazines. I don't read them. They bore me dead. I'm not proud of this. Most people think I'm arrogant. I'm not. I'm just shy. I don't like being around people. You make me shy. You make me shy, and I don't like it, and I don't like cocktails, and I don't like small talk, and I like literature, and I like books, and I listen to books while I work. All day, and I like it quiet, and I hate noise, and I hate public places, all these things in the contemporary art world that artists hire public relations companies, and have 150 assistants, and I don't get any of that. I have two assistants, and most of the time my wish they didn't exist. They're helpful to me, very, and they're good. I like them, and they're nice people, and they're good, and I do my best to have them happy. For them to be happy, and I get them paid well, and do my best for them to be happy. But if I won the lottery, I get out of this world and I just do my things to see them. Like, I just do my animals to see them. And I do my shows to make people smile, and that's it. I make these big installations. And I like to go when people cannot identify me. And it's very beautiful and very emotional, very fulfilling to me to see people in awe, like, wow, this is so beautiful. This is so uplifting. And just bringing so much beauty to be uplifting statements. No statement, just beauty, just smiles. No pretending to be intellectual, no teaching, no proving my intelligence. I may not be. I'm not trying to be. I'm not trying to prove it. I don't need to prove it. I think that going to places, reading one movies or whatever, it's a terrible thing that we all know. That life is hard, painful, that war is unfair, that there is hunger, that there is that the fish are dying, that it's just not surprising. I want to surprise myself. I want to surprise my people. I want to make things that are just beautiful. I don't want to get bored. I want to make things different every day. I want to make different objects in different directions all the time. Sellable, not sellable. Fortunately, now I have a dealer in New York that is very open to my ideas, and he's not pushing me in any way to stay to any. So it's very good for me, willing to back me in any position I am. I had a very bad experience in Miami, and that was very painful and destructive to me. I think that
here you can see the pieces of electronics.
This is another carpet I made. They invited me to a house in New York. These people that I really like called No Longer Empty, that take over empty spaces in New York. And they took it over a old nursing home in the Bronx, and they invited me, and I picked up all this garbage around the house, and I made this carpet out of the garbage that was in the house. All these, I don't know, pieces of silver
These are all pencils. A lot of work, believe me. A lot of work. But I listen to books. So I listen to classical literature mostly. I look at classical paintings mostly, and I look at classical. I like classical paintings because of the craftsmanship. I look at classical sculpture because of the craftsmanship also. It impressed me. It impressed me that these people know Ariel. You know? This idea that you spend time, no fear, no. This guy was feeling backwards. Yeah, the guy fucked me. There are a lot of unexpected things that happen in life.
There's this There is this thing, this Viking thing in Miami. Every Friday, every one last Friday of the month, is like thousands of people biking. Never seen it. He's brought in traffic. Yeah, anyway. I was there once and they look like zebra crossing. That's where I got that idea. Because you remember this game, or obviously you remember this game when you were a kid, like playing with clouds. These clouds look like an elephant and look like a boat and they look like a dinosaur or whatever that is. This is how I do it all day long. So this is how it works. These are keys. The key of knowledge. I had a tutor when I was going to school in New York that was a conceptual artist. And he made an engine that had geometrical shapes on quartz. And I remember that, and I made this, I guess, making sort of copy of his work, but in a different way. Key of knowledge. I really like this. Nobody ever got it. Tennis rackets. These are coins. This is a very old piece. It's called sentimental. You can see. It's a sentimental one. I made this a long time ago. This is baby bottom needles. With tags in the inside of the femme fatale. These are rubber leaves. This is jute. These are, I don't know how to say that. Forget it. This is a dominant, it's called dominatrix. I really like golden balls. Find them beautiful. I just like them. Aesthetically. I made it because I like them aesthetically and I like the idea. This in the left, in the right hand side. The guy has a book that has animals on the book he's reading. So I just made it because I thought this was on the book that were the animals on his head. So there was all these animals on his head. He was not really about this sort of last names from Native Americans. That was sort of the way it is. In the houses of Native Americans, there are some of the last names of people. My last names are all these animals that are on the head and the houses. That have balls. But and this one is sort of tropical. These all on there are books. These are paintings on wire connected to the past, connected to the sea. This one, these paintings, fortunately for me, went to the MFA, the Museum of Fine Art in Boston, and the permanent collection of the Museum of Fine Art in Boston. It's a very different year. I
really like this one.
The Thinker. Okay.